Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in the rope and I couldn't even fight back.
Welcome back to Four Corners.
Come
News,
on now, dog.
And you've tuned in to
Come
This
on,
Week
man.
In Israel. Right, This Week in Israel is brought to you by Solomon's-Closet.com. You got to make sure you put the dash in there, the Solomon's-Closet.com, where you can find all the latest fashion for men, women, and kids. Low prices and fast shipping.
That's
Solomon's-Closet.com. Don't forget the dash. As you can see, the different array of shirts and coats and windbreakers that they got. I think they call them windbreakers now, but you can check that out on solomons-closet.com. All right, make sure you go check that stuff out. All right, and you can also follow us. Let's bring it back up real quick. You can also follow them on solomons-closet.com or Solomon's Closet on Facebook. Go on Facebook, follow the page. You'll stay you can stay up with the new items that come out. Hell, if you got an image of, or if you brought anything, you've got an actual image or a picture of a Solomon's Closet shirt, go ahead and put it on the Facebook
right.
page,
upload
man.
It, y'all.
Upload it. Let everybody see your drip, your righteous drip.
That's
all right?
right. Support the team, y'all. Come on.
That's
you know
right. That's Solomon's Closet on Facebook. All right. So this week in Israel, we had a major wedding in Israel. Deacon Asaph's daughter got married. All praises to the Most High. So it was established the house of Officer Ira. All praises to the Most High for that right there. It was an excellent, excellent wedding. If you didn't get to watch it live, you can go back and watch that on IUIC. But you see the garments. You see the bridegroom and the bride there. You see the wedding garments. Nice,
man.
You can't tell us Israel ain't got style, man.
Deke showed up. He was
Yeah,
playing.
Look at Deacon Asaph giving away his daughter.
That's
all praises
right,
to
all
the Most High.
What a weighty mind.
Born in this truth That's and given right. away in this truth. That's what it's about. That's Deacon Asaph's wife right there. And you can see Deacon Asaph walking his daughter down the aisle. And giving her away, as the scripture says, as it's supposed to be.
Right.
That's how it's supposed to be right there scripturally. And that's the husband, Officer Ira from New York. And I believe he's Zebulon. From the tribe
yep.
of Zebulon. So all praises to the Most High for that. And this
that's
is what it's
right.
all about right there, man. Scripture says in Ecclesiasticus 7 and 25, it says, marry thy daughter. And so shalt thou have performed a weighty matter, but give her to a man of understanding. That's what Officer Ezra, Officer Ira is a man of understanding. And Deacon Asaph followed the scripture, and also Mother Naama also gave away their daughter to Officer Ira, and that's a beautiful thing. That's what we all strive
that's
for
right. That's right.
in the truth, especially captains and officers and soldiers with daughters, man. So it's in the prayers, and hopefully they endure and they can have a righteous wedding
right.
just like that, all right?
That's
all praises
right.
to the Most High. Also this week in Israel, Jackson, IUIC Jackson,
all right.
Mississippi, man. They knocked it out, man. How many days of camp?
100 days of camp.
100 days of camp, man. All praise to the Most High. Shout out to IUIC Jackson, Mississippi for that, man. Shout out to Captain Get a Liar and the officers down there in Mississippi, man. They went out there and brought out the word of God. Lord's will sealed some people. They planted the seeds of the word of God into those that are lost and looking for the truth. And Lord's will, you know, the Most High waters those spirits that receive the word of God, like it says in Mark 4. Although we got more pictures than that. What's going on, man?
Yeah, we got some more.
Pay attention, baby. All right, so you see the nice little cake they got there, and all praise to the Most High, man. Oh, man. And they got some wine.
What?
Boots on the ground.
Boots on the ground.
100 days camp, man. Damn.
That's right.
What brand is that? I need that. 100 days camp wine. All praise. Shout out to the sisters, man, that served the man of the Lord, that supported the troops.
That's right. That's
during
right.
that 100 days of camp in IUIC Jackson, Mississippi. Shout out to those sisters, man. Because, you know, they got to give up some things, too. So they've got to be a helpmeet for their Lord to make it through those 100 days. Because that ain't easy thing to do. So shout out to the sisters that supported the troops as well with their 100 days at camp. Also in the news this week, IUIC Mobile, right? They, you know, kids is going back to school. It's that time of the year, around August, September. Start back up school. So in IUIC Mobile, what do? They went on a skating right? Took out the whole little congregation, had a little back to school event. Took the
That's
kids
right.
out, man, to enjoy some skate. You know, Israel love to skate, man. You know, that's our thing, man.
I'm telling you, it's like floating, just watching it. I can't skate, though.
Yeah.
I can't. I'll bust my ass.
Yeah, the damn skates be heavy as hell, man. I be trying to turn.
Man, break a whole ankle.
To forget about skating backwards.
Oh, sheesh. I don't know how I do it. Judah do it good.
I'm all right, man. It's all right. But shout out to IUIC Mobile, man. We might go skate down here in a long time. Last time we went, man,
that's when
we had a bunch of injury reports around here, man. People was on the IR after that, man. Sheesh. But all praise to the Most High. Shout out to IUIC Mobile, man, for going on that school event, back to school event, skating ring. Also Orlando, they've been having a training session with the Young Prophets of IUIC Orlando. And this week, they learned how to lay tile. All praise to the Most High. And that's a skill that you could have, working with your hand. Remember, Christ was a carpenter.
Right?
So these brothers down here, these young prophets, they learned how to lay some tile. So all praise to the Most High for the young prophet mentors teaching these young men a skill that they won't learn in school.
Actually, they're trying to take that type of stuff.
They did, They took away
school.
Trade school. They took away home ec.
Home ec, there we go.
That's what it was called. Home they ec. Took away home
a wood
ec.
Shop.
Yeah, wood shop. Right. Yeah. So shout out to the IUIC mentors in Orlando for doing a good deed with those young prophets up there, teaching them how to lay tile. Also in IUIC Columbia, they got a billboard.
A billboard up. Yeah, all praise.
This week they put up a billboard.
There
man.
We go.
All praise to the Most High right there. That's nice. It was in a heavy traffic area where everybody's going to see it. I know it looks backwards right there, but there it goes right there. So that's what it says. The Bible has the solution to our problems. All praise. That's a dope graphic. You can find out more about the truth on IsraelUnite.org. So all the people that are down there in Columbia, South Carolina, which is a predominantly black city as well. And it's a predominantly black city, a college town as well. So all them college students are going to see that thing. And they'll never forget that, because that pull back up that image real quick of the billboard. I want to show you something that your eyes can't miss. You can't miss that black Jesus right there. You can't miss that. That's unmistakable. Your eyes are going to be fixed on that right there. And your mind's going to say, who is that man right there?
It's like a beacon of light.
Yes, exactly right. And we're not saying that that's exactly how he looked, but we saying that's the biblical description. Dark, it's like you've been burned in a furnace with hair that looked like it was wool. All right. So on his head and on his face. So shout out to IUIC Columbia, man, for putting up that billboard. Lord's will, you know, when the depression hits down here in Miami, we can get down here.
That's right.
They trying to damn Man, they trying to, they want arm, legs, and a damn lung for down here, man. But, hey, whatever, man. At least they doing it in Colombia, right, man. Hey, also, this week in Israel, the IUIC Ecuador.
Ecuador, yeah.
The documentary dropped this week, and that's with Deacon Yahshua. I think it was Captain Zev, Captain Abiel, and the rest of the officers. I think officers Issachar, Yamagan. Was down there, Israel. A lot of them brothers was down there. Officer Cornelius.
Yeah. A lot of mighty warriors from the Northern Kingdom tribe.
Oh, Officer Joshua, I think, was down there as well. All praises to the Most High, man. Shout out to the Northern Kingdom for doing the work, man. And matter of fact, we got a the clip.
That's right.
If you haven't had the chance to check it out on YouTube on IUIC Events, you can go to it. It's also on IUIC TVs. Mm-hmm. But here's the promo clip for it. Let's play the promo clip for the people. Northern Kingdom just as rebellious as Southern Kingdom with that word when the image of Christ come out. Man, that's cold-blooded. Sheesh. Mission 41, Ecuador. Hey, I'm going to tell you right now, real talk. That's probably one of the best promos that I've ever seen in Israel, man. Shout out to the composer of the music on that thing and the editor of the video. And oh, man, that's dope, man. Make sure you go check that out. That's on IUIC Events. It's also on IUIC TV. That's the Mission 41. That is the Ecuador mission. Shout out to Northern Kingdom for putting in the work of the Lord, man. Also this week in Israel, man, the captain's still putting in the work, man.
That's right.
15 minutes with a captain. Captain Yadin. Yadin. Captain Yadin. Dropped a nice 15 minutes with a captain casting down Mother's Day. That's for all you, what Bishop be saying? I always love my mama. It's for you mama boys out there.
Mama boys.
Captain, you didn't cast down imagination. Show you exactly where it came from, all right? It comes from Egypt, man. Come up out of the ways of spiritual Egypt, that's Babylon. Right. And return unto the Lord, all right? Also, Captain Uziel is coming with a video tomorrow, right? And what's it called?
Confess Your Faults.
There you go. Confess Your Faults, man. Focusing on James 5, verse 16.
16,
yeah, James 5 and 16. That's with Captain Uziel. That's going to be dropping on the IUIC Captain's page. Make sure you check that out. I think they drop at 11:45, 12 o'clock every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Those 15-minute videos drop. On Tuesdays, they've got another show called What Christianity Never Taught You.
Right.
And this week, Captain Barnabas, he dropped What Christianity Never Taught You, but he dived into the topic entitled The Sabbath Ain't Never Been Sunday. And in that video, I'm telling y'all, man, go check that out. He dropped proof, historical facts of people admitting that ain't nowhere in the Bible it says the Sabbath is Sunday. It literally tells you that. It tells you in the video, white folk made it up.
Oh, yeah.
He has a video of a white man literally going into the historical annals of it and say, yeah, we made this whole thing up. It come from us. It's not of God. You can find it nowhere in the Bible. Your Sabbath ain't never been Sunday. Make sure you go check that out, man. That's also, those drop on Tuesdays.
On Tuesdays.
Okay? And on Thursdays, Captains in the Classroom, on the Captain's page, Captains in the Classroom. those videos dropped. So this week it was Captain OC. Captain OC dropped a video this week. It's called The Signs
of the Times.
Signs of the Times, right? So make sure you go check that out, man. It goes into coronavirus and food shortages and how it's prophesied in the Bible that it was to come. They let you know that the Bible's a true book.
Right, right.
Because we see those things happening. That drops those captives in the classroom on the IUIC captives page. Those drop on Thursdays, that's all right? So make sure you go and you subscribe to the IUIC captives.
We're going to keep you busy. Israel, we will keep you busy. So there's no idle time in Israel. There's always something to do. And as you see, the teaching is getting sharper and sharper.
Yeah.
Those scriptures that you struggle with, you have now classes that target them directly.
Yeah, they focus right on
right,
those things.
Right.
So there ain't no excuses. Because what it say? The scriptures talk about the understanding of the Lord shall flood the earth.
Right.
There you go right there. IUIC's flooding the earth with it.
That's right.
Every day, it's a video or some understanding on God that's dropping that you can feed your soul with. And also on Tuesdays, guess who dropped videos on Tuesday? Bishop Nathaniel. Hey, I'm going to tell you this right here, too. Check this out. Because I know people be busy. We be fake busy.
Right.
I know black folk be fake busy. I watched this when it dropped. This one is God Ain't in the Church. That's with that Thunderbird guy you see in the corner.
Right.
That's the same guy that cussed out his congregation for not getting him a Movado watch.
Yep.
Guess who also was in his church? The same guy that killed his wife because he was a sodomite in the church. And Bishop went and found all the videos dealing with that because he pieced it together.
Mm-hmm.
He got a sodomite in the video, cussing everybody out in the church and putting everybody on blast, saying everybody was effing everybody in that damn church, and you know it.
Damn. Y'all better come up out of these churches, Israel.
I'm telling you.
Come up out of there.
Man, if you ain't watched that shout-out Tuesday right there by Bishop Nathaniel,
you
better make sure you go and watch that, because that is going to reveal to you that the Christian church is full of abominations. Yeah. Sodomites having sex with everybody around there, marrying women to cover it up, and the damn pastors is out here asking for damn Rolex watches. Where they do that at?
The hell is this?
When they teach in the Christian church, where they teach for hire. I tell you, that's where they do it at. Also this week in Israel, man. Matter of fact, before we go on, you can subscribe to IUIC events. You can find that on YouTube. Just go on there,
type in
IUIC events, and you'll subscribe to it, and you'll be able to get notified when those shout out Tuesday videos drop. Every single Tuesday by Bishop Nathaniel, all right? That's IUIC events on YouTube, all right? Also, the throwback video of the week by Bishop Nathaniel is Sin and Spirits of Bondage. Now, if you ain't never seen it, you can go on IUIC Miami and check that out, because that's one of the old school videos when they was in the basement.
Right, right. Classics. You
classics.
Had to log in. Hopefully it was enough room for you to
To log in. Then when the microphone sound like the voice of God.
Yeah, I love that.
Those is when Bishop still bringing out stuff.
Right.
He did, but that back then, that's when we was hungry for the word, when it was a video every week or two.
Right.
But now you got them every day, so people. But you go back and check those out, man. That's how we got to where we are with Israel not in Christ now.
Right.
But Sin and Spirits of Bondage, go check that out. That's on IUIC Miami. It's a Throwback Thursday video of the week. All right. So the scripture of the week. Let's bring it up for the people. The scripture of the week. Let's read it for them, officer.
1 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 24.
Read it out.
Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize?
There you go. That's what this is what this is about. We all supposed to run the race. The race is to the kingdom of heaven. And you got to be on that straight and narrow path. So make sure that you run it, that you may obtain it. There's no point in running a race if you ain't going in it to win. That's what the scripture's saying through the mouth of Paul, all right? You're in this race to get the kingdom and eternal life. Make sure you're on that straight and narrow path so you can obtain the kingdom of heaven. Don't waste your time in this repentance. Do what you're supposed to do, all right? Go ahead. Finish the rest of it on that.
So run that ye may obtain.
Run that ye may obtain, because that's what it's for. That is exactly what it's for. Also, the quote of the week comes from all of our bishops. All Bishop Nathaniel, Bishop Kanai, Bishop Yawasab. Let me read that for him, officer.
Leaders discuss solutions. Novices discuss problems. And Negroes discuss others.
Gee-wee.
That's real leadership quotes right there.
Yeah.
Y'all make sure y'all download that to your memory.
Right. Hell yeah.
Leaders discuss solutions. Mm-hmm. Novice discuss problems. And Negroes discuss others.
Damn, that's cold-blooded right there, man. That's something to live by right there. Yeah. If you're a leader of your nation, start bringing solutions to the table.
There you go. There you go.
We ain't worried about the damn problem. We know it's a problem. Now we need a solution.
That's right.
Don't be a Negro and just gossip about it.
Right.
Right? So take that wise quote from the bishops. Leaders discuss solutions. Novices discuss problems. And Negroes discuss others. Basically, they out here gossiping. Right. All right? All right. So it's time for the meme of the week. You ready for this one, Captain?
Bring it
Harris?
Out. Bring it out.
Pull up that meme of the week for the people. Read that for them, officer.
Press 2 for English.
Press 2 for English.
AT&T rep.
Uh-huh.
Thank you for calling AT&T.
Oh, man.
Thank you for calling AT&T. Yeah. That's exactly what happens,
Elon,
man.
Picked up,
I'd be pissed. Press 2 for English. Thank you for calling AT&T. All right, may I help you? I don't understand you. What'd you just say? Can I have your name and your number? No, I'm not giving you my credit card over the phone. Right. No.
You gonna give it to your
No, I want to speak to somebody from America. No. Press 2 for pull it back up again, because y'all know this be happening, man.
Yeah, all the time.
Somebody said meme facts. You dang all right. Read it again for them.
Thank you for calling AT&T.
Thank you AT&T. For calling AT&T. Damn. That's exactly what damn happened, man. I be wanting to hang up, but you can't hang up. Nah, and you know why? Because your ass been waiting for 15 minutes on hold. Yep. You can't hang up, so you got to deal with Elam.
How, Sway?
Hey, and I'm telling you right now, I've learned to speak some damn Elamite English. I kind of understand them now.
You got them.
Yeah. May I have your number,
please?
You've
been on wait for a while.
9-5-4-9-4. We do not offer those services. Sorry.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right. I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom. Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I have an important message about your leaders in the Christian church. Your bishops, pastors, reverends, and ministers are all lying to you and leading you straight to damnation. The truth is, you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the biblical Israelites, according to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Jesus Christ is a black man with white wool hair, according to Revelation chapter 1, verses 14 and 15. We as the Israelites must keep the commandments in the faith of Christ to receive salvation, as it is written in Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. I've challenged and debated Christian authorities all over the world on these issues. Not one of them has been able to negate this truth. Your pastors have led you astray, worshiping pagan holidays and false gods, just as in the days of old. So join us on our mission to restore the true nation of Israel before the decree goes forth. The work is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Visit our website at israelunite.org or call us at 855-484-4842 to learn more and visit our schools. Shalom.